Well, yesterday also marked the 40th anniversary of the deadly collapse of the Manila Film Center, which was a project of then First Lady Imelda Marcos. Labor leader and presidential aspirant Leonie D. Guzman led the candle lighting in honor of the workers who died at the construction site. D. Guzman expressed confidence the Filipino people will reject the presidential candidacy of Bongbong Marcos and his vice presidential running mate, Sara Duterte Carpio.
Paniniwala ko, marami nang nawala. Marami nang nawala doon sa palpak na pamumuno ni Duterte sa nakalipas na halos 6 na taon. Sa palpak at marahas na pamumuno. Kaya tingin ko ay lumit na lang lumit ang bilang noon. At saka lumalakas yung kilusa ng pagpigil sa pagbalik ng mga Duterte at ng mga Marcoses sa ating bayan. Kaya malaki ang aking kumpiyansa na hindi mahahadlangan ng taong bayan ang mga katulad na ni Marcos at ni Duterte na ang paraan ay marahas na pamumuno, pagnanakaw at kalawalan ng pagkilala sa karapatang pantao.
A third petition is filed with the Philippine Election Commission seeking to disqualify Bongbong Marcos from the 2022 presidential race. The petition was filed by the group Karma, or the Campaign Against the Return of the Marcoses to Malacanang, or end martial law. It asked the poll body to bar Marcos from running for president due to his 1995 conviction for tax violations. The petitioners include former Congressman Satur Ocampo. He insists public officials who violate the country's internal revenue code are perpetually disqualified from holding public office. Marcos's camp dismissed Karma's petition as black propaganda.
We have anticipated the filing of multiple cases, whether it's a disqualification case or yung mga naunang petition to cancel his certificate of candidacy. Dahil nga marami talaga na layunin ay direct ang kandidatura ni presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos. At tuloy-tuloy kami paghahanda at kami ay focus. Ang kabilin-bilinan ni presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos is not and never to engage in gutter politics and elevate the level of political discourse.
Majority of Philippine House lawmakers throw their support behind presidential aspirant Senator Bongo and VP hopeful Davao Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio. That's according to Congressman Michael Aglipay, who was among lawmakers present at Tuesday's dinner in Malacañang with President Rodrigo Duterte. Aglipay says representatives of 6 parties and 2 blocs, which make up around 240 lawmakers, have committed to support the tandem. He adds Duterte ally, House Speaker Lord Alan Velasco, could also pull in the group of his father, League of Provinces President Presbytero Velasco Jr. Aglipay believes that could be enough for Senator Go to beat current presidential frontrunner and Duterte Carpio's running mate, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.
I can only speak on behalf of my friend of 34 years, Speaker Lord Alan Velasco. If he can master 85% of the congressmen to support Senator Bongo and Sara Duterte, I think that is a big factor that they commit until the end and they don't change their commitment. His father, Governor Presby Velasco, is also the president of the League of Provinces. If Governor Presby can get 85% of the governors to support Senator Bongbong and Sara Duterte tandem from now until the end, I think they have more than a big chance than anybody in this game.
The party of Bongbong Marcos, meanwhile, brushes off President Rodrigo Duterte's moves to get his allies behind his daughter and his loyal aide.
If you will watch our campaign of the Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, especially under the leadership of Senator Ferdinand Marcos Jr., we just do what we have to do. We do not react. If we watch the other side, if we watch the left, if we watch the right, we cannot move on.
The Philippine president's daughter, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio, takes over the chairmanship of the Lakas CMD party that is fielding her vice presidential bet. Duterte Carpio took over the post just hours after it was offered to her by then party chairman Senator Ramon Bong Revilla Jr. Duterte Carpio only joined Lakas CMD last week, but she has also been adopted as a guest candidate of the People's Reform Party, which was founded by the late Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. A top pandemic task force official of the Philippine government throws his support behind the presidential candidacy of Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso. COVID-19 testing chief Vince Dizon is working with Moreno's team as its deputy campaign manager. But Moreno's campaign chief, Lito Banayo, reveals that Dizon has held that function since the middle of this year. Banayo says Dizon is mainly in charge of doing research designs for surveys and focus group discussions.
Yeah, he's been on board. No, kaya lang, hindi nga publicly dahil meron pa siyang government position na hinahawakan. No? So, but he has told Malacanang and even the president himself. At pumayag naman si presidente.
Pero
parang sabi ni presidente, buhay mo yan eh. No? I mean, I understand that. No?
ABS-CBN News tried to get Dizon's comment. He has yet to reply.